icy skies. It's no great surprise what we see with every new day. We're so proud to say, Adelaide, it's you and it's me. 'Cause we're growing together, Australia, you and me. And we're building together, Australia, you and me. And we're growing together.
See what all the fuss is about with Ita, Joe, Jess, and Sarah. Beaming across Australia, it's Studio 10.
We are feeling fabulous and pretty flammable this morning, aren't we? In our 80s frocks, our get-up,
all curly and curly.
Yeah.
What about this? The perm. I love the perm.
It was big. Everything was big, wasn't
Everything
it?
Was big. Hair, big makeup. Shoulder pads.
Yeah. Yes, well, my shoulders are aching from these.
Big hair and big personalities. Tanya Zayeta, welcome
Thank
to the
you.
Show.
Hi, everyone. Hello. I'm so happy to be here today of all days too, just to rock out the fingerless gloves, which I have been known to rock out on a Sunday at brunch anyway.
I love it. Ita, you would have ruled with an iron fist back in 1988.
Mm. Oh, no, not really. Oh. No, but 1988 was, well, it was a very significant year for me, I guess. We're still doing a lot of HIV/AIDS work. You know, the Grim Reaper had made its appearance the year prior. And so we were still establishing guidelines for people, and December 1 that year I launched the AIDS quilt, the AIDS memorial quilt, which was, it's a beautiful sort of patchwork of people who we lost to the AIDS epidemic, and it tells the story, so their lives are not forgotten. It's the most emotional thing. It's very, I launched it here. I did some work with it in Melbourne, and you really do want to, it's very hard not to cry when you see the quilt. Oh. It now resides in the Powerhouse Museum in Sydney. It was presented to them by the Bobby Goldsmith Foundation in 2007. And Bobby Goldsmith was one of the first people to die of AIDS in Australia, and he is commemorated on the quilt. Right. And his foundation, the Bobby Goldsmith Foundation, is the oldest AIDS charity now in Australia.
Yeah. We've done a lot of fantastic work.
And
so
then
much good work.
I suppose the other thing for me was I started my own company. I was editor-in-chief of the Sun Herald, and I realised I couldn't go any further.
Woo!
That's getting the AO. That's with my daughter Kate. Look at the hair.
Wow.
And I was made an officer of the Order of Australia in 1988 for my work in public health education, notably for chairing the National Advisory Committee on AIDS.
Ita.
Oh, wow!
And,
oh,
gorgeous.
And that we were doing mock-ups of my magazine, Ita, which we launched in 89, but in 88 we were doing mock-ups. This was a cover that never made it, but we were just testing the we were testing it ourselves.
Wow.
Stunning cover,
yeah.
Ita.
Now, just speaking of modelling, you were modelling back in 1988.
Oh. Well, attempting to. Look at that. No, that's not a model. That's a photo of me scowling. That's not a modelling shot, but that's me thinking I look cool.
Gorgeous.
With long hair, big hoopy earrings. So I was 17 in 1988. There's a modelling shot of me and my...
Is that you?
Yeah, that's me.
It's like an Elle McPherson shot. Can we say that again?
But what is hilarious, though, is I was modelling, like, in inverted commas. I took a year off my studies. I just finished high school. I worked in a cafe down the road making terrible cups of coffee for people who paid far too much for it. I was dating a nightclub owner. And
you're wearing very, very, very high-legged swimsuits.
All of that stuff was like,
yes, that seems like very high maintenance.
Gorgeous.
Very high maintenance, that sort of swimsuit.
No.
You look like Elle McPherson.
Well, missing this part, probably.
But you're all legs. Yes. You're all legs.
Wow.
Joe beat that.
Yeah, well, that certainly explains the weird dreams I've been having.
How old were you in 88,
Jane? Well, I had actually... 1988 was my first year of high school.
Oh.
As you can see, I'm a pretty cool dude right now, but I think you'll agree I was an even cooler dude back then.
No.
New Balance shoes.
Yeah, and you'll also, if you look closely, you've got the Parasilk tracksuit.
Oh.
And then, of course, you've got the sort of zigzag fluoro pink
jumper
and purple T-shirt on there. Look at that.
Joe, you were cool even back then,
and
weren't
that's your
you?
Sister next to you?
I was so cool that my only friend was my little sister and occasionally my mum.
Oh, but look at you.
Oh. You look like something out of Oliver.
Yeah, that was, we were raised as Amish.
Oh, but you look beautiful. You've got gorgeous long eyelashes and, oh.
Yeah, that didn't help me then, Jess.
Oh. Tanya, what were you doing in 1988?
Ah, seriously, 1988, I was 18 and I think I just finished my natural beauty therapy course studying health and fitness and things. Funny how life does a full cycle, which I'm doing a lot now, but also, like everybody else, I was very busy doing the locomotion. Who wasn't in that era? Oh, and oddly enough, I did all my schooling in Melbourne, and there was a whole circle of friends that one day wanted to aspire to be something. There we go, Danny Minogue and I, and we ended up all around the world together. Yeah, quite.
Wow.
And now you're back in Melbourne.
Yeah, so
now
I'm back living in Melbourne also, and still friends with the whole gang. Mm. But yeah, funny, you go around the world and you end up back where you
started. Why did we leave 1988? It's such a good year.
Oh, no, I'm so glad we did.
No, look at you. You can carry this off every day.
I want to borrow that swimsuit sometime.
Can we still get those calendars with Jessica's modelling work? I wouldn't.
We'll talk about that after the show.